Good morning, Daniel. If you could state your name for the record, please.
My name is Daniel Friesen.
Okay, you have 10 minutes to make your presentation.
Okay, thank you. Good morning, everyone. I'm here today also on behalf of Winnipeg Police Cause Harm, a community-centered police abolitionist group committed to defunding the Winnipeg Police Service and reallocating resources to life-sustaining services. I'm here specifically to comment on the photo radar enforcement section of the second quarter budget update. In the second quarter budget update, the WPS projected that they would go roughly $4.4 million over budget, due in part to reduced revenues from photo radar. The City of Winnipeg Photo Enforcement Safety Program was established in 2003 to, quote, augment conventional enforcement for the purpose of enhancing traffic safety. Despite the city claiming the program is operationally efficient and effective, the Winnipeg Police Service also says it lacks data to properly evaluate its photo speed limit enforcement program and confirms the company that operates the cameras is largely free to decide where and when to dispatch mobile units around the city. To be clear, I'm not calling for an end to the photo radar program. I'm calling for a shift in priorities away from reactionary and punitive methods of safety towards a forward-thinking model that seeks to treat the root causes of problems in our city. This can begin in part by removing revenues from the photo radar program from the police budget and putting them towards programs that proactively make our community safer. I'm sure you're all familiar with the intersection of Grant and Thurso, a photo radar enforcement zone that is responsible for 20% of all mobile enforcement tickets in the city annually, nearly $30 million in fines since 2013. Out of more than 900 locations legally eligible for enforcement, about 70% of tickets are issued between only 15 locations. Despite this knowledge, the city has taken little action to actually improve safety at these locations beyond enforcement. Though traffic enforcement can help with safety, it is not a public safety strategy. Specifically, when enforcement is the city's primary road safety strategy and also relied upon as a notable source of revenue, it gives the appearance that the WPS is not truly interested in improving road safety if they rely on revenue from these fines to balance their budget. If the photo radar program is actually about safety, it should then work to make itself unnecessary by putting the funds collected from fines into forward-thinking projects and green infrastructure that encourage people to drive slower, reduce the number of cars on our roads, and make our communities more healthy, sustainable, and vibrant places. The photo radar program should be treated as a means to an end so that one day we won't need these punitive measures because we will have adequately invested in and addressed the current gaps that exist in the road safety system. It is clear that those 15 streets that account for 70% of tickets are not designed to encourage safe driving. Trying to calm traffic simply through enforcement is not a long-term strategy. To quote Councillor Matt Allard, enforcement is one tool. It helps, but there are other things that we can do as well. Enforcement doesn't influence everyone, and people have certain driving habits that are influenced by the engineering of the road. If the goal of traffic enforcement is to create long-term safety for motorists and pedestrians, then the revenues from photo radar tickets should not be fed back into the WPS's budget and should instead be used for projects that actually increase street safety permanently and for the long term, such as trees on boulevards and protected bike lanes. Councillor Kevin Klein already publicly called for the revenue from photo radar tickets to be removed from the police budget and invested in traffic calming infrastructure earlier this year. Yet as it stands now, the WPS's operating budget for traffic enforcement has increased by 21% since 2013, while the overall police budget also increased by 29% in the same period. The WPS does not have the power or the ability to design safe streets, only to retroactively give fines after people have already been endangered by speeding. Not only is the deterring power of fines truly limited, but if the WPS is going to go over budget, in part due to reduced revenue from fines, then it is clear that this model is not working. It is clear then, for actual long-term community safety, we need to be proactive. We need to encourage people to drive at a safe speed by thoughtfully designing our public infrastructure, investing in transit and active transportation, and moving away from the car-centric model that is currently draining our city's resources and endangering citizens. This is done by reducing the police budget and moving away from a cycle of enforcement and inaction. We need to move towards a funding model that redirects monies currently set aside for the Winnipeg Police towards initiatives that address the root causes of harms and works to provide sustainable and proactive solutions. With this in mind, consider that last year the city took in $13.6 million from photo radar, with $8.1 million of that going directly to police. That $8.1 million could and should be invested in complete street or traffic calming infrastructure that benefits the city as a whole, rather than going back into the pockets of the highest funded department in our city. Such infrastructure has already been proven in cities that, much larger and with worse traffic problems than Winnipeg, such as New York, Mexico City, and Chicago. I'm urging the police board to use the city's resources to work towards actual community safety. The benefits of safer roads for motorists and pedestrians are obvious, and our current way of doing things won't get us there. Let's use our city's resources to make it a better place instead of continuing to put them where they continue to cause harm. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your presentation, Daniel Friesen. Are there any questions from the board members? I have a few questions. First of all, Daniel, are you aware that the province has called for a review of the photo radar program?
Yes, I am.
Okay. Are you also aware that the city of Winnipeg has called citizens to provide input into traffic safety?
Yes.
Have you lent your voice to this process?
I have not yet, no.
Okay, are you planning to?
Yes, I likely will.
Okay, and what programs would you consider would improve traffic safety here in our city? You mentioned that revenue should be directed towards programs that will improve traffic safety. What programs can you mention that would lend itself to this?
Totally, well, I mean, I'm not an engineer that designs roads, so I'm not an expert on that. But I know that there's lots of research out there that I'm sure council is more than capable of finding that allows for reducing speeds on roads. For example, just having trees on boulevards, it creates. I know there was a presentation just last week that already mentioned this. Having trees on boulevards creates an effect that makes the space look more enclosed and psychologically causes people to drive slower. I see you're shaking your head there at me, but that's actually a fact. You can look it up, Allie. Or having protected bike lanes would also encourage people to drive less. $8.1 million alone would pay if we bid protected bike lanes like on Sherbrooke Avenue, that would $8.1 million could pay for roughly 70 kilometers of protected bike lane, which is an exorbitant amount, obviously. But if we know that there's these 15 specific areas that are consistently responsible for speeding, for endangering people, and there's no money being put into improving these areas, when we have the data, we know that these 15 specific areas out of 900 are consistently a danger to people, and there's no improvements being made to them. What's the point of this program? Is it just a cash cow for the police, or are we actually trying to make our city a better place?
Okay, thank you. Thank you for that input. Allie, did you have any? Yeah, you did have a response. Go ahead.
No, I just have a question. Sir, you mentioned many ideas to change the infrastructure of our city. Fine. But you didn't really answer Councillor Chambers' question. What programs would you suggest this money to go into to help educate our drivers to not speed so much?
Again, the infrastructure is like a program because it creates a psychological effect where if the street, like at Grant and Thurso there, have you driven there, Allie? Yeah. So, you know, it's a big wide open area. It's four lanes of traffic, two in each direction, plus service roads on either side. It's very big and open, and that creates a psychological effect where people drive quickly because they think, oh, there's nothing around. I can drive quickly here. It's like a highway, it feels like, even though the speed limit's only 50. And that's why people feel that, well, I should be able to drive more quickly here. And so, now let me finish my point here. And so by investing in infrastructure there that causes the space to feel less open, that also allows for infrastructure for cyclists, for transit riders to drive the bus board the bus safely. There's many apartment buildings near there. I'm sure lots of people who live in that area use transit. By providing supports for people to safely cross that road, people with disabilities, where in an area where there's people speeding, people with visual impairments or mobility issues trying to cross the street where there's common speeding issues, that's not safe. And so by investing in complete street infrastructure, I want you to look that up, Allie, because that's an important concept. We can actually make space for people that works for everyone and not just for people who can afford to drive a car.
And to that, I just
Allie, before you just before you start there, if I could just have you direct your questions through the chair to the board member and not directly to the board member, please. Go ahead, Allie.
I have a couple questions. First of all, I do work with civil engineers, so I see how, for civil engineers that do a lot of projects for the city of Winnipeg, so I see how all that thought process is put into effect. And it actually baffles me how Chief Peguis, for example, between Henderson Highway and Lage is sometimes a massive speedway because there are young people who are speeding and get, you know, $800, $900 speeding tickets. And I don't understand how planting a tree is going to help them slow down. Or another.
Well, it's not one tree.
No. Okay. Just let me finish my statement now.
You're reducing my point to absurd point.
There's a space down Keniston between Taylor and Sterling Lion where every few feet there's a sign 60 kilometers an hour. And quite often there's no construction workers there, but the signs are still there. And people are still going 80 or 90 down there. So how do signs help drivers slow down psychologically?
Right. So it's not just about signs. It's about making the street narrower. It's about providing people options other than driving a car to encourage there to be fewer cars so that we don't have to have our roads on a 150-year renewal cycle, so that people actually ride the bus and then there will be fewer cars on the road, more people drive cycling, then there will be fewer cars on the road, and then we can actually have space that's not just for cars in our city, and then their streets will be narrower, which will cause people to drive slower. Again, I'm not a civil engineer, but these are well-documented concepts.
So narrower streets will slow people down?
Yes.
Fascinating. You have data showing that?
Not with me right now, but you can talk to your civil engineer friends about that.
Oh, I do.
Yeah, it'd be our traffic engineering. These all sound like great initiatives and initiatives that could be forwarded or used in consultation with the citizen request for input to our traffic study. And I encourage you to participate in that and provide information on things like modal split, where active transportation, mass transportation, and other mechanisms of transportation are utilized as we move people around our city, moving towards a million people population.
Can I ask the board one question? Will there be further discussion on removing these funds from the police budget and towards being invested in these initiatives?
Again, thank you for your presentation.
Can I have an answer to my question? Will there be further discussion?
We can discuss. But again, I encourage you to participate in the City of Winnipeg's survey with respect to traffic input.
I will. I just want to make sure that my presentation is actually, you know, taken seriously and that these funds are, you know, not actually being used for traffic safety. They're used for reactionary methods and for increasing the budget of the highest funded department in our city that is continuing to waste money by sending cops to ride on empty buses.
Thank you for your presentation, Daniel. We'll move on to